In today's episode, we're building a Ron Hock smoother, so let's jump right in.
Welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop. Today's episode is sponsored in part by Highland Woodworking. Visit their website at highlandwoodworking.com. And also by Lee Valley and Veritas. Visit their website at leevalley.com. And by viewers like you when you make purchases through our various affiliate links at mattsbasementworkshop.com.
Hey folks, welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop podcast. So for today's episode, we're starting the construction of this great Ron Hock smoother. This is a all-in-one kit. It arrives when you purchase it. You can get it from Woodcraft Highland Woodworking. You can get it from Ron Hock's site at hocktools.com. And it has everything you need for it. It has all the wood. It has the blade. The only thing you need to do is bring the time and the glue and maybe a hand tool here or there, which really comes down to more or less just a couple of clamps and a drill. Other than that, that's pretty much all you need. So rather than talking a lot about this at the beginning, let's go ahead and jump right into the construction. One thing I'm going to warn you is the sound is going to be a little bit different than what you're listening to right now. When I shot the video for this series, the mic I was using wasn't quite working the way I wanted to, so it's going to be picking up a little bit more of the background noise than normal, but I promise you'll still be able to hopefully understand everything that's going on with this. And we're going to be doing a multiple part series on this. In fact, the first part is more or less kind of getting everything roughed out to the basic shape. And then in the second part, we'll come back in and start refining it. And who knows, maybe there'll be a third one because you'll probably have some questions to ask about it or not. Who knows? We'll see. But anyways, though, like I said, let's jump right into the episode. Today, we're building the Ron Hock smoothing plane. And this kit is really easy. This is everything that's included with it. We have the blocks for the body itself. We have the sides, the maple wedge, a dowel. These dowels will actually help us to assemble. And of course, we have that Ron Hock blade and chip breaker included with the kit. Now to build it, it's really simple. So let's get started. So let's go ahead and start the assembly. Now we're gonna start with our two sides, our front block, and our rear block. And the rear block, you can see, has this dado area, this recess removed so that the nut from the chip breaker will fit right in there. So what we need to do is, let's begin by getting the sides aligned with the back. Now the back has this chamfer, and you'll notice on each side that it also has a chamfer. So according to the instructions, the first thing we need to do is to get that back kind of lined up, and we want to have the chamfer line up all the way across the back. Now, before we get too far, what we need to do is take this cross pin and we're going to have that fit into the sides. One recommendation before you get this far, try and get the dowel into the sides first, because this dowel was a little sticky for me in the sense that it really did not want to go in. And one thing I'm going to recommend is try and pay attention to the end grain of the dowel. Have the end grain kind of running in the same direction that the piece is here. Basically, to me, it kind of looks nicer that way. I don't know. It's just, I guess you could have it going cross direction. I guess it really doesn't matter the more I think about it. But let's go ahead and just get this in position. And because it will be just a little snug, it might splinter a little or give you a little issue. Don't beat on it too much. That will definitely ruin it. But don't be too shy about getting it in position, because it's going to be crucial. This is what's actually going to be having the wedge tight against it to hold the blade in place. So you want to make sure that it fits nice and it can throw your whole build off. So we've almost got this in position. Like we said, we're going to line up those chamfers and we're going to make sure that this piece is flush with the bottoms of the sides. And we're almost there. Oh, it keeps moving on me just a little bit. If it's not perfectly flush here in the back, don't worry about it. The main thing is to get those chamfers lined up, and that looks like where it's supposed to be. Oh, and I just moved it again. So let's go ahead and we'll get the clamp in position, and then we'll put the final touch on that to get it right where we need it. And that looks like it's just about right. And there we go. That's good. Again, nice and flush. Okay, so we'll kind of pull that together. Now, with the back in place, we want to put this front block. According to the instructions, we want to have the front block, the bottom of it, 3/16 of an inch away from the bottom of the back block. And this is going to be for the sake of the mouth for which the plane is going to be, the blade is going to be sticking out of. So let's go ahead and just kind of get this in position. And we'll put the clamp on a little bit. And we're going to then play with this mouth. Now, as I mentioned, this is where the blade is going to be protruding from. And according to the instructions, we want it to be about 3/16 of an inch. I happen to have this 3/16 inch brass gauge here, so I'm going to use that. Now, it appears that this 3/16 of an inch, this end is fine at 3/16, but this one is a little narrow. Because this one is perfectly fine, I'm going to go ahead and just go with where it is at this point. What we'll end up doing is when we're sanding this whole thing to make it nice and flat, because no matter what we do, to some degree, it's not going to be perfectly flush at this point. We'll just go ahead and, if we need to, come back and clean up this mouth so that we can get the blade to protrude all the way through it. If you don't have a 3/16 inch gauge, that's no big deal. A recommendation in the instructions, because they probably anticipate that this is going to happen. Let me just clamp this in position here. There we go. That's ready. Everything looks good, as you can kind of see there. That's good. There's the bottom. One recommendation that they had made in the instructions was, if you don't have some sort of gauge, just take the blade, put it into position, bevel down, because this is a bevel down plane, and where the blade itself is going to rest inside that mouth, it should be about 1/16 of an inch up from this bottom. So you could make a line on that block just to see where it's going to come up, and you can use that as your alignment to figure out if the mouth is, if the blocks are placed where they need to be. Thankfully, like I said, I have this little gauge, and it's just a piece of brass, and that works out perfectly fine, so I don't have to worry too much. At this point, everything is kind of flushed up. It's kind of clamped in place. That wedge is where we need it. In fact, I'm just going to double check to make sure that, yep, that's good. Okay. This, while it should be kind of flat, it kind of moved a little bit on us. This we can flatten up once we're done. You'll notice here on the top that the wedges, the blocks themselves, are a little bit below the sides. That's the way it's designed. That's no big deal. So let's go ahead and set this here. And we're ready then to start drilling holes for these dowels that are included. And according to the plans, and this is really great because, of course, there's this one whole sheet, including a little schematic on there to help you line everything up. According to the schematics, we're gonna drill a dowel hole here, 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 and here, and that's gonna help us with the alignment, get everything glued up, and then we're pretty much ready. So we have to do that on both sides, and you can easily use just a hand drill or a drill press. And I think I'm gonna end up using just a hand drill this time. Okay, with everything ready to go, I'm bringing in this piece of maple to kind of help me raise this up enough that I can do this. Now, remember, we're just going to put these dowels in, and these are simply for alignment. So according to the plans, we're going to put two at each end here. I'm just going to grab my quarter inch drill, and it doesn't really matter. You can go ahead and kind of, if you want, just for the sake of decoration, to have them exactly lined up on every single place. In every single spot, the same exact place, but I think I'm just going to put mine here. I've already made a couple of marks. Let's just go ahead and drill. You don't need to drill the full length of the dowel. Again, these are purely for alignment during glue-up. I can see it sure looks like we are far enough in there. And we will put this first one in. Oh yeah, we are. And just to make sure, we'll look at that height. Yeah, we're down to the subsurface here. Again, just for alignment. Don't worry about having to get too deep. We're just gonna take these off and flush cut them. So now we'll just go ahead and repeat it up here. Now remember, of course, I should point out, this is just a little flush of it, and we have that nice little chamfer, but we'll be able to just put this right here
And if you are a stickler, go ahead and draw those lines so you know exactly where everything is. One way to show that you've gotten through to the other material is you will notice that there is some different colored chips coming up. Alright, we're through. So I'm just going to repeat this on all the other corners. So with all the holes drilled for our dowels, we're almost ready to take these clamps off. But before we do that, we want to go in here where the ramps are for each one of these blocks, and we want to mark exactly where those are. So we're going to take a sharp pencil, and we're just going to kind of mark them out. It's no big deal. It doesn't have to be perfect. It doesn't have to be exact. What we want to do is, when we take this apart and we glue it up, we want to have these reference lines so we know where not to put the glue, because we don't want the glue showing in this area. This is where the blade's going to be. This is where the shavings are going to be coming out. So we want to minimize as much of the glue out as possible. That's done. Let's go ahead and take the clamps off because we're not going to need these, except for maybe when it comes to the actual gluing. Let's go ahead and take our wedges out, or our blocks out. And we're now ready to start the glue up. And let's do that next. So we're ready for the glue up. We've taken everything apart. We've got our dowels. We've got our pieces. One thing I'm going to do is, as you can see where we marked for those wedges at. We know that the chamfer is equal to the back. And rather than applying the glue to the sides, I'm going to apply the glue to the sides of the front and back block. Remember, this is not quite as tall as this. So in my absent-mindedness, I would probably end up putting glue all over this, and then I would have all this squeeze out on the top. So instead, I'll put it here. And it also gives me a little bit more control when it comes to this area right here, because remember, we want to minimize any kind of glue squeeze out in here. We're probably going to have some, but we'll have to clean it up just a little bit. Anyway, so we'll go ahead and we'll apply the glue, and we want to make sure we get a decent amount on here without getting too crazy, because after all, we don't want to have to deal with a lot of clean up. All right, so we'll be careful as we get to it towards those edges. The bottom, I'm not too worried about if I get a little there. The top, I'd like to kind of keep it a little bit cleaner than I might normally. So I think this wood is really drinking up this glue. So I've almost got this. Yeah, there we go. And I've got a little bit in the dowel holes. Now remember, again, the dowels aren't for structural, they're purely for alignment. So I think we're pretty good here. Let me go ahead and get a little of this excess glue off. All right. At this point, I'm going to take my dowel and I'm going to insert it in here. So we'll use this as part of that alignment. So we've got our side, we know which one is going to go where because we see the chamfers. Go ahead and get these in position. Oh, a little glue thumbprint there, but that's no big deal. All right, so that's pretty good. All right, now I'm going to take the dowel that's going to go in here. I'm going to apply just a small amount of glue. To be honest with you, this is tight enough that I really don't need to, but I get paranoid sometimes. So let's go ahead and apply just a smidgen to this. Okay, wipe off the excess glue. Go ahead and we'll put this in here. And it's already starting to swell just a little bit, so it's going to need a little persuading to get in there. So I'm just going to come back in and... Okay, I can feel that. Yep, there it is. It's tapping out over there. All right. I had said something about getting that grain in a specific way, but I'm not going to worry about it. So let's go ahead and let's bring in that block. We'll use this to help elevate everything up. Again, let's go ahead and, oh, we should do the front, because once we get everything into place, it's going to be difficult to do that. See? So in that case, this goes over here. Again, apply a liberal amount. And if anything, I think this is probably the part that's going to take us the longest to do, right up there with getting the blade sharpened. All right. A little excess there. Let's go ahead and add our dowels. And we'll just tap these in just to... There we go. Okay. Get those kind of lined up. There we go. It's going through. And again, if you get a little glue squeeze out here and there, it's no big deal. No problem at all. Yeah. See, the thing is, I don't have really any play in here because those dowels are holding everything in position. So let me just... back over here. Alright. We're almost done. See, we are getting a little squeeze out inside there, but that'll be easy to clean. And the same if you get a little squeeze here on the sides. We're going to end up sanding all this stuff nice and flat. Alright. So we're almost done. Get this ready to go on. So let's apply our glue liberally, but not too much. Snug. Let's go ahead and get this block out of the way. Let's come back in here with our clamps. And we'll get it in a position. There we go. Get some nice pressure all the way around. Alright, we got a little squeeze out here, but that's no problem because we'll just clean it up. We're going to be flattening this bottom anyways. We're going to be doing the sides. Let's check that mouth. Oh, yeah. There we go. That's right where we want it. Of course, like we do, we can check it with the blade. So at this point, we're just going to set this aside and let it dry. And maybe this is a good time to take the blade and to actually hone it.
All right, this is a pretty good place to stop right now. Like we said, we've got the basic construction put together and we've got everything kind of gluing up in the clamps, and we're gonna start moving into refining it from this point forward. Really, when it comes down to it, this is a really super simple project. It can be easily accomplished in a weekend, but the result is you get a tool that's gonna last you a long time. So it's definitely, who knows, maybe it'll inspire you to build more tools. But anyways, if you want more information, again, visit Ron Hock over at hocktools.com. You can even see a video of Ron building the kit himself. And I think he makes it even easier than how I make it look. But we'll come back next week and we'll finish this whole thing up. If you have comments, questions, suggestions, you know how to get a hold of me. It's at mattsbasementworkshop@gmail.com. And you can stop by the website at mattsbasementworkshop.com, where you can also leave comments in the show notes for today's episode or any episode you've heard in the past or seen in the past. One thing I am going to ask is if you stop by the website, please could you take a moment to take our Matt's Basement Workshop 2012 listener survey. It's going on right now as this episode is being released. And all we want to do is just get a little basic information from you so that we can tailor fit some advertisers that will benefit all of us. Because, well, as you should be aware of, every episode of Matt's Basement Workshop is totally free. And so I need just a little assistance in covering things like hosting service and maybe even buying new equipment, specifically cameras or computers, to be able to keep bringing these episodes to you free week after week. So anyways, though, again, if you could just take a few minutes to do that, that'd be greatly appreciated. And it's over at the website, mattsbasementworkshop.com. Just look for the show notes for today's episode or the past couple of episodes, and you'll find links in those show notes and they'll take you right to it. And as always, I promise, no spammers will get a hold of you from this point forward. Your information is completely private. The only thing I ask is if you want to get entered for a chance to win a free Matt's Basement Workshop t-shirt, just leave me your email address and you'll get in for that drawing. Otherwise, you know what? Don't worry about it. You don't have to do it. It's completely optional. Anyways, that's going to do it. I'll be talking to all of you later. Straight grains and sharp blades. Come back next week when we'll go ahead and start wrapping up this construction.